美国当选总统拜登表示，他长期以来一直认为特朗普总统不适合担任总统职务，但是在周三国会暴乱之后，要由国会决定是否对这位共和党总统进行第二次弹劾。拜登1月8日对记者表示，他的工作重点是遏制新冠病毒大流行，确保快速接种疫苗和提振经济。当被问及众议院民主党准备弹劾特朗普煽动暴力行为的立法时，他表示国会决定要做的事由他们来决定。拜登呼吁对这一事件进行调查，并对暴乱中丧生的美国国会大厦警官的家人表示同情，并表示将追究肇事者的责任。
Let me begin by expressing my deep sympathy for the family of Capitol Officer Sicknick.Who has died in the line of duty. Our sympathies and our concerns go out to his family, and the people responsible should be held accountable, and they will be. And so I'm focused on the virus, the vaccine, and economic growth. What the Congress decides to do is for them to decide. They're a bunch of thugs, insurrectionists, white supremacists, anti-Semites,Six and is not enough. I mean, come on. You know, these shirts they're wearing? These are a bunch of thugs. Thugs. And they're terrorists, domestic terrorists. And that'll be a judgment for the Justice Department to make as to what the charges should be. But the fact is, they should be prosecuted. They should be prosecuted. The difference here is, this had the active encouragement of a sitting president of the United States.And the way in which the breakdown in security occurred needs to be thoroughly investigated. I'm not going to prejudge what it was, but the idea that these people were able to just march up the stairs, march in, and do it in the way with we had, there's a great debate. I don't know the answer. Great debate now. Was the governor of Maryland correct when he said that I was ready to send in the National Guard? I couldn't get authorization. What happened?It deserves a full-blown investigation. People be held accountable, and steps taken that something like this could never happen again.
Should President Trump, in your estimation, remain in office?
I didn't think, look, I've been saying for now well over a year, he is not fit to serve. He is not fit to serve.He's one of the most incompetent presidents in the history of the United States of America. And so the idea that I think he shouldn't be out of office yesterday is not the issue. The question is, what happens with 14 days left to go or 13 days left to go? And I think that what 81 million people stood up and said, it's time for him to go. And the United States Senate,voted 93-6 to confirm that we should be sworn in. We were duly elected. So I think it's important we get on with the business getting him out of office. The quickest way that that will happen is us being sworn in on the 20th. What action happens before or after that is a judgment for the Congress to make, but that's what I am looking forward to, him leaving office.